الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد الأمين نبي الأنبياء وخاتم المرسلين وعلى آله وصحابته والتابعين لهم بإحسان. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. قال أمير المؤمنين عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه: يمنع العقل امرأ أن يخدع. يمنع العقل امرأ أن يخدع. وهذه العبارة فيها من الحكمة ما لا تتخيله العقول، لا تتخيله العقول.
In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful, the all merciful, the especially merciful, all praise is due to Allah, the Lord of the worlds. May His peace, blessings, mercy, honor, elevation, and protection be upon our Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his noble family, companions, and followers until the Day of Judgment. Glory be to you, O Allah, and far from imperfection are you. We have no knowledge except that which you have taught us. Indeed, you are the all-knowing and the all-wise. The leader of the believers, Umar ibn al-Khattab, may Allah ta'ala be pleased with him, said, one's intellect should prevent them from being deceived, or intellect should prevent one from being deceived. And this statement has very deep wisdom for those who think about it, beyond imagination. There are two types of intellect. There's one's natural intellect that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives to someone to the level that people can even call them a genius. And this individual, through their that intelligence, can ascend in knowledge above the level of his teachers a billion times. And of course, despite that, he would remain to be a student. And then there's the intellect that is taken through gaining the benefit from the passing of time, gaining lessons, and paying attention, having using one that intelligence which is absorbed from experience. As such, Duraydi said that whoever does not increase in lessons by the passing of their age and their time, then it is more befitting for them to be blind than to be guided. There's a young man who is called the genius young man in Mauritania. So once he was taught just even the beginning education that they told him A, B, C, he said, no, the foundation of knowledge is taqwa, is God consciousness and obedience. And what is the beginning of taqwa?
Alif.
At-taqwa. Or
وَأَلْزَمَهُمْ كَلِمَةَ التَّقْوَى وَكَانُوا أَحَقَّ بِهَا. يعني بدأ عقليته يعني مباشرة، يعني ما يحتاج لعقل. واحد آخر كتبوا له ألف باء تاء فقال إن كانت الأحرف على هذا المنهج لا نحتاجها
كيف يعني؟
ألف باء تاء قال خلاص دعها أنا انتهت المرحلة. هذا ذكاء وعقل يضعه الله تعالى عقلية بعض الناس ويترعرعون يعني ناس يعني حتى يأخذون من الأحرف الأبجدية يوزعونها على الحكم. واحد قال له ألف باء تاء قال إن كانت الأحرف كلها على هذا خلاص لا تحتاج بعد ذلك أن تمدها بألف ولا بواو ولا أنا سأتصرف معها. عندما بدأوا بأي بي سي قال خلاص هي على هذا المنهاج لا نحتاجه.
فهم التركيب يعني ما يحتاج إلى شرح.
نعم.
So there was another student that as soon as they started teaching him the letters, you know how they have the beginning, the first page with just the letters, then the next page about how they're cut in half, and then how they go together, and then. Once they taught him the letter, he said, don't worry, I'm going to I've figured out how the rest of it goes. So then there are some people like that who have the wisdom and the perception, that type of intelligence, where with the information they are given, not only do they come to the right conclusions, but they also derive from even being taught alif, they derive that, look, alif, at-taqwa, the first letter, is also the first, so they derive the wisdom from even ABC.
معنى العاقل الشخص إذا رأيتمه تتكرر عليه الخديعة فاعلموا أنه غير عاقل. معنى ذلك قول عمر رضي الله تعالى يمنع العقل امرأ أن يخدع. إذا رأيتم الإنسان تتكرر عليه الخديعة خصوصا من وجه واحد فقولوا خلاص أنت لا بد أن تحكم على نفسك أنك غير عاقل.
So in what Umar radiallahu anhu said that intellect or intelligence should prevent one from being deceived, meaning that if a person keeps on being deceived through the same way and from the same avenue.
أن يخدع هذا أصلا ليس بعاقل ولكن إذا كان يتكرر عليه من وجه واحد.
Then he can safely know that he has no intellect. If a person is deceived already, this is a sign that they're not paying attention, that their intellect is deficient. But if a person's repeatedly deceived from the same avenue, then this is a sign of not having any intellect whatsoever.
واحد أمس خدع بمسألة واليوم خدع بها وقبل شهر خدع بها وما زال يواصل بها هذا شيء عجيب.
That a person yesterday he was deceived with something. And then today he's deceived. And tomorrow he's going to be deceived by it again. This is remarkable. That you, Abu Bakr, tell me that you know, meaning me, the translator, do you know anyone who is in the... Don't you have many examples of people who this happens to them? نعم جدا. There you go. أنا حك.
رجل خصوصا الإنسان بلغ 30 سنة بلغ 40 سنة خصوصا إذا يكون عنده دين متجه إلى الدين فيخدع كم من مرة وبعد ذلك يرجع إلى الفخ هذا خلاص 30 40 سنة تجاوز ومتجه إلى الدين يخدع من وجه واحد.
A man who is 30 years old already, 40 years old, and he is considered practicing and cares about the deen, and still the same pitfall that he fell into, that he was deceived by, he keeps coming back to it again and again, despite being deceived and knowing that he got deceived. And then he returns to it as if nothing happened.
ويرجع يضحك.
And he goes back laughing, smiling.
أين كنت؟
Oh, where were you?
كنت في المسجد.
Oh, I was at the masjid.
أين كنت؟ كنت في المركز.
I was at the center.
أين كنت؟ كنت في المجموعة الفلانية.
Oh, I was at that gathering.
أين كنت؟ كنت في الرحلة الفلانية.
I was at that رحلة.
أعطينا الذي أتيت به.
Okay, tell me what you actually gained.
كم أتيت لهذه الحلقات واعطينا ما 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 الذي تعلق.
How often did you go to those gatherings? Tell me about the actual benefit that you took from those gatherings.
ألا يمنع العقل امرأ أن يخدع؟
Shouldn't your intellect prevent you from being deceived?
أفوق هذا أنتم عندكم كلكم أنا المشاهد وكونوا معي على إنصار. أفوق هذا خديعة.
Tell me,
أنتم كلكم.
All of you, tell me.
أخبروني.
Is there any deception over this?
لذلك ابن عطاء الله السكندري رحمه الله تعالى يقول لا تصحب من لا تنهضك حاله ولا يدلك على الله مقاله. أنت إذا حضرت حلقة وأهلك ما حضوك وأهلها ما حضوك على أن تستفيد وأن تأخذ كما قال تعالى يا يحيى خذ الكتاب بقوة وآتيناه الحكم صبيا وحنانا. وموسى عليه السلام قال لقد لقينا من سفرنا هذا نصبا. إذا أنت لا تأخذ الهمة بحيث إنك يتعلق بذلك بك من ذلك المجلس مسائل تبقى فيك إلى أن تموت ما هي فائدة عليك حضور هذا المجلس.
If you're not taking your knowledge seriously enough, you're going to those gatherings as if your knowledge is a joke. Not taking your knowledge seriously enough, not knowing what Allah says in the Quran about taking that knowledge. Allah says, O Yahya, take that book with strength. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says about the journey, the long journey that Musa alayhi salam and his companion were traveling until he said that we have encountered great difficulty or difficulty in this travel of ours.
هل جاءوا بالذي ذهبوا به حاصلين عليه حافظنا أو جاءوا يقولنا تقابلنا مع رجل صالح ورجعنا.
Do you think they just went and then they came back and then there was no benefit that they gained? Do you think there was no benefit from that knowledge that he gained?
قص الله علينا ما
Do you think they just said, oh, we saw a righteous guy and we went home? Is this the knowledge that they gained? That Allah would honor it by mentioning to us their journey and mentioning to us take the book with
strength.
Allah explained to us in fact in detail for us to take the lessons also from what exactly happened between Musa and Al-Khadr. As such, Ibn Ata'a Allah Sikandari said,
لا تصحب من لا تنهضك حاله ولا يدلك على الله ما قال.
Do not accompany the one whom their state of being does not uplift you, and nor does their speech lead you to Allah.
أي خديعة فوق أن يحضر الإنسان كم من درس ويخرج منه ما أكد عليه وما جعلت له وثيقة إياك أن تخسر ما تعلمت معنا. أي خديعة.
Could somebody be deceived so much thinking
that you're going to all of
these religious gatherings or seeing so-called whatever speeches and so on, and then there is no indication and it's kind of a consensus that they're going to go empty-handed. Rather, they're never reminded, they're never told, make sure that what you learn, you hang on to, you have to memorize and understand. How can there be a deception over this? Do you know of any deception? You tell me. Allah that this is, do you know any deception greater than this? It's hard to think of one because this is a person who has lost this world and the next and thinks they're doing great.
أي واحد منكم الآن يتردد على شريكة دنيوية أو على مصنع دنيوي مرتين أو ثلاثة ولا يستفيد منه ويعود إليه بعد ذلك. أي واحد
Which one of you would ever go to work for a day or two and not get paid and then you know you're not getting paid and then to keep going?
أي واحد منكم يتردد على شركة أو على مصنع.
Would you go to a company, would you go to a factory and then
ويرجع بدون شيء وبدون خبرة.
Without any experience, you don't gain any experience and you don't gain any pay. Who would go there? Oh, you're not even giving you an internship, we're not giving you pay, we're not, just, you're coming. And that's it. Which one of you would keep going back to that job? You could never imagine this happening, this just seems ridiculous. And if you actually do such a thing, and then you tell your family about it, they'll call you insane.
ولكن إذا رجعتم إلى أهلكم بدون أن تفيدهم وبدون أن يستفيدوا منكم وبدون أن يعلق بكم شيء من مجلس علم فهذا أمر عادل. أين كنتم؟ كنا في المسجد، كنا في المسجد، شو رجعنا؟
يا رجعتم إلى أهلكم.
وكم رجعنا؟
How many times have you gone back to them after the masjid, after those gatherings, those speeches, and so on? And then you go back home. Oh, where were you at the masjid? That's it. There's no benefit that they gain, no knowledge that they learn, no purification, no nothing.
للزائر للراجع ولا المرجوع إليه يخبر الآخر بشيء.
They're not expecting anything from you, and you're coming home not expecting and not in your mind to give them any benefit that you gained at the masjid.
خروجك ورجوعك يعني شيء واحد.
Coming and going, you're the same person. No benefit happened.
إنما تخبرهم بأنك تذهب وترجع.
All it is that you're telling them you're going and coming.
ما شاء الله رجل ما شاء الله يتعود المسجد دائما.
That they're saying ما شاء الله. This guy goes to the masjid all the time.
واجلس به وما له ما هي الحكمة من المجلس من المسجد وما هي هو المسجد الذي أسس للعلوم ولكن ما هي الحكمة بأن تذهب إليه ليس له صلاة ركعة ليس له.
What is the wisdom of going to the masjid to pray
rather than أول الحكمة من صلاة الجماعة حتى تلي الجماعة تصلي فيها ليس.
Why is there such a thing called صلاة الجماعة؟
أول حكمة ما هي؟
What is the wisdom? Why is it multiplied so much in reward and so encouraged?
من مولود يقول من حكمة الجمع انتفاع الجهلاء أول ما مسألة تنتفع.
The first Muhammad Maulud mentioned the first wisdom, the first point of that is so that the people who are ignorant can benefit by coming and learning.
مع تلقي بركات الفضلاء ما هو معنى الفضل؟ ينهضك حال ويدلك على الله المقال.
And gaining blessings by being around the righteous people. Who are those virtuous people? The people who just being around them uplifts your state closer to Allah. And their speech guides you to Allah.
وبتعاهد اللقاء نظام للفة يحصل له القيام. بتعاهد اللقاء يحصل نظام الألفة من المسلمين يتعاونوا على البر والتقوى. وبتعاهدهم وتعاهدهم وتقابلهم.
Builds a community around obeying Allah subhanahu
wa ta'ala.
That they encourage each other, that seeing each other, everybody struggling to get better and apply the rules of the deen, that now they strengthen each other as a bond to implement the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and righteousness and piety. So these benefits, do you see any of these benefits? Benefiting of the ignorant people.
تلقي بركات الفضلاء واحد ينهضك حاله ويدلك على الله مقال.
Gaining the blessing of being around virtuous people who their state of being uplifts you and their speech leads you to Allah.
وبتعاهد اللقاء يوم بعد يوم تزداد ألفة تتعاون على البر والتقوى.
And by getting used to seeing each other, holding each other accountable day by day, then you encourage one another to do goodness and righteousness.
أخبروني أنتم الحاضرون جميعا ولا تكتموا الشهادة ولا تكتموا شهادة الله. أخبرني أنت الأول وأخبرني أنت الثاني وأنت لي وأنتم وأنتم معناها أخبروني.
Tell me what of these benefits you have.
أنتم وأنتن.
The women here and the women here.
أي خداع فوق هذا.
What deception is there greater than this?
خديعة واحد يتردد مرتين وثلاث الحديث ورد في الحديث وهو من جوامع الكلم لا يلدغ المؤمن من جحر مرتين.
It was narrated this concise speech, subhanAllah.
لا يلدغ المؤمن.
A believer is not stung from the same hole twice.
كم قرأت من الكتب مرتين وثلاث وأربعة وخمسة وستة.
How many times have you read books once, twice, three times, four times, five, six times?
وتخدعون في كل سطر منه مرتين.
And then every line that you're reading, you are deceived in it double.
لا تحفظونه ولا تفهمونه ولا تتذكرونه.
So not only do you memorize it and retain it, but also it isn't explained to you properly to begin with.
هذا صحيح ولا؟
نعم صحيح،
نعم جدا.
معناها نحن إذا كنا هو في الدعاء، في الدعاء المعروف عندنا رويناه من مشايخنا، ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا، اللهم لا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا، ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا، ولا تسلط علينا من لا يرحمنا. اللهم لا تجعل مصيبتنا
في ديننا. That oh Allah, do not make our calamity in our deen, do not make this dunya the biggest of our concerns or the extent of our knowledge, and do not make the fire our end. And do not send upon us those who do not have mercy upon us. These gatherings that you think that it's a part of your deen to go to, what do they have but these three? These majlises and classes.
هل هي مشتمل على غير
هذا؟ الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا نبلغ علمنا ولا
علمنا. اللهم لا، اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا. أتعرف أنها مخططة على الدنيا؟
That do you not know that these gatherings are based around the dunya?
اللهم لا تجعل مصيبتنا في الدنيا أولا.
That oh Allah, do not make our calamity in our deen. That's actually we mentioned before that in the
Quran.
This is a calamity in our deen. A person is coming towards for the sake of the deen, and they don't gain any of the deen. They go home with a compounded ignorance.
اللهم لا مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ترجعون منها وقلوبكم معلقة بالدنيا.
That you go home and your hearts are attached to the dunya, in fact.
ولا تسلط علينا من لا يرحمنا قوم يخططون لكم الخداع. ولا تسلط علينا من لا يرحمنا.
And do not make the dunya the greatest R of our concerns or the extent of our knowledge.
ولا تسلط علينا من لا يرحمنا.
And do not send upon us enemies who will not have mercy on us.
ما هؤلاء يخطط ماذا يخططون لكم؟
Those people who are profiting off of these gatherings, what is their plot? What is their point? What function, relationship do you have with them?
ما هذا السماء الذي سيسقط علينا بين عشية وضحى؟
So that where is your intellectual superiority that you're claiming, that you're saying you're we're a first world country and we're educated because we went to college and we have degrees and we learned this.
أنت قرأتم العلوم النفسية.
You learned psychology.
وقرأتم المحاماة.
And you learned, you became lawyers.
وقرأتم الدكتورة.
And you became doctors.
وقرأتم ما قرأتم والسماء سيسقط علينا بين عشية وضحاها.
And all of this, where is this the reality of this intellect then, while the sky is falling?
وكأن السماء ستنزل علينا من شدة الهول.
And it seems like the sky is falling and you're claiming to be intellectual and you keep on doing what you're doing.
وأنتم ما زال والله لو جاء صبي على الفطرة فصبي على الفطرة أكمل سبع سنين ما يرضى بهذا الحال.
I swear by Allah if there was a 7-year-old kid
سبع سنين أكمل على الفطرة
uncorrupted, still on his pure nature, he will not accept to be in the state.
صبي يرضى أنه يدخل المجلس على الفطرة ويرى التاريخ الإسلامي أين كانوا صبيان المسلمين وأين كانوا جنات كان صبي المسلمين يقوم ويقرأ بكتاب الله تعالى من أول إلى آخره لا يخطأ أصلا.
That a child hears about the history of the Muslims and sees the reality of the Muslims nowadays in contrast and though the reality of those gatherings in contrast, right? Where are we and where were they?
صبي كان يقف عد 15 سنة مثلا لا يخطأ في القرآن أصلا وعشر سنين أحيانا لا يخطأ فيه لا يفتح مصحف.
You would see 7-year-olds and 10-year-olds memorizing the Quran and not without a single mistake, not needing to open a mushaf for the rest of their lives.
هذا شيء عجيب جدا. هو أنتم لا تعلمون في الحديث أن من علامات هذه الأمة أناجلهم. انظروا ابن حجر العسقلاني، أناجلهم في صدورهم، أناجلهم أنا مصاحبهم في صدورهم.
That one of the miracles of this ummah and one of the signs of this ummah is that their Qurans are in their chests.
أناجلهم مصاحبهم في صدورهم لا يفتحون مصحف النصر.
Their mushaf, their Quran book is in their chest.
ألا تعلمون أن الإمام أبي حنيفة كان يختم القرآن في ركعة واحدة؟
That do you not hear that نعم
الإمام أبو حنيفة.
الإمام أبو حنيفة used to recite the Quran in one ركعة.
ركعة واحدة. ناس عندنا تاريخنا موجودة، كيف نخدع من ألف مرة من الباب الواحد اللي ندخل منه نخدع منه مليار مرة ولا ندري؟ عندنا تاريخنا.
We have, despite our history, we are being deceived not once or twice or a billion times from the same avenue.
هذا باب العلوم بأصلها. ما بقي باب من العلم لا يدرس هنا، والناس تدخل وتخرج، وعندما تخرج وتدخل ماذا الذي قرأت؟ خليني نفكر. سبحان الله، هذا اللي درسنا مع الشيخ الفلاني. الله ناسي، كانت كثير من الدروس ولكن ناسي. لابد يصاب صداع قبل أن يبدأ.
They say that this is our institution, this is our school, this is our academy, this is our whatever of knowledge, and all the types of knowledge and the branches of knowledge are taught by us.
كانوا كثير.
And there are so many sheikhs that we have in our institution. And then a person can get a degree from us, and they get their degree, and then you ask the person who just got their degree, you tell them, okay, mashallah, tell us all of the beautiful things that you learned. And they say, oh, wait, let me think. But we had so many sheikhs and so many wonderful classes and so on, I just can't think of anything right now. He can't remember the names of his
sheikhs.
Because they're more than the pebbles.
هو ما في، أنت الآن تعلم ما في هنا مبحث قطات إلا وفيها 20 شيخ.
There's no, you know, over here in America, there's no like what's it called, a dog house or cat house, except that it has
20 شيخ.
Except it has 20 شيخ in it. There's شيخ everywhere you look apparently.
هذه خديعة، هذه نحن تتكرر على الخداع من كل واحد، كل واحد يخدعنا ونرجع نقول تبارك الله، جزاك الله خيرا، أحسنت خدعتنا أمس ما فكر اليوم والليلة وغدا وسنرجع أيضا، سنرجع. ما هو الدروس القادمة؟
This is a deception in deen, and instead of people realizing they've been deceived, they say, okay, when's the next class so we can come?
صحيح.
That's right. So do you have intelligence or not? Do you have intellect or not?
Sometimes Sheikh he give class for free, sometimes he give money, but most time he give with money.
Sometimes that Sheikh does offer free classes, but sometimes you have to
pay. Oh my God, he give class for free. Okay, mashallah, tabarakallah. May Allah give him tawfiq, says his action. هو ما هو لا يعلم شيئا. free from what? From nothing. He's from free. He gave free from free. Nothing. He has nothing. لا تتكلم عن الباطل. هو ما يعلمه. هو سيفتح الكتاب وينظر إليه وسيسقط عيناه تسقط عيناه.
He is going to open a book in front of you and read to you from.
يسقط تسقط عيناه.
كيف يعني؟
من شدة التركيز ما يحفظ منه حرف واحد.
That his eyes are going to pop out of his head because of how much he has to focus on that book, because he doesn't memorize any part of that book. It's not just for reviews.
أنت وهو سواء. أنت كابك لو كنت تعقل. هو قول عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه لا يخدع المؤمن لا 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 يمنع المرء يمنع العقل امرأة أن يخدع. أنت كابك من خدع يوميا كل يوم.
Enough for you if you are intelligent. Just the fact you see that he's focusing on the book. to know that you and him in regard to the knowledge in that book are equal.
هو لا هو يحتاج أن يضع المرجع بعدما في الدرس الثاني ولو بعد الساعة يحتاج أن يضع المرجع يخاف ينسى.
That he has to put the bookmark every time in the class to make sure that he can know exactly what he's covering next time so he doesn't forget. It's very right.
ما أنتم ما يكفيكم هذا الخداع؟
يقول أين كنا؟
قل لهم.
هو في وسط الدرس يقول أظن أن قد قرأنا هذا من قبل. في وسط الدرس أحيانا. That sometimes they start a class, and this was my experience, and then we had forgotten to put the bookmark from last time. Oh, you didn't put it? Did you put it? Oh, okay. Where did we leave off? Did we cover this? I'm not sure. And then we start halfway through the class. Oh no, we did cover this.
هو ما كفر هو ما غطاه ماذا غطاه لماذا يقول كفر؟
How then obviously you didn't cover it. What's the difference between covering and not covering it if you don't know it?
ولا يعلم من أنا بدأ ولا من أنا ختم.
وأنا أشتكي أقول أنا لن أتذكر شيء من هذا هذه الطريقة لا أتذكر منها. يقول لا بأس عليك أن فقط بعد هذا ستستطيع أن تفتح الكتاب بعد ذلك وتدرس منه لأنك يعني تفهم الكتاب الآن. تستطيع عندك الخلفية الآن.
هي خلفية.
أنني قرأت الكتاب معه.
هاي الخلفية كذبية. والبيت كذبية.
So literally I was told, I said, I even complained. That much intelligence I had that I said, look, I'm not retaining any of this.
وقلهم كم خدعت. قلهم كم خدعت.
But I said, I'm not remembering any of this. I know that none of this in the future, I'll be able to use it the way that we're learning it. I'm not memorizing anything. I'm not learning anything. I'm not having any homework. I'm not passing any tests. It's just we're going over the book beginning to end. And the teacher is asking, we're looking through the dictionary for every other word.
Who?
So, well, and then now. And then he said, keep going, it's okay. As now, trust me, after this way that you went through, if you're studying it, you'll be able to in the future go and go through, teach somebody else in the same manner that I'm teaching you, that you'll be able to. Why didn't you tell him how stupid am I to be? I see you looking. Tell him how foolish am I to continue in this? I see you looking at. لا ثم
وتتغلط تحتاج
تعبنا شيخ من أن يكون يعني أمام بعض ونحن ساكنين بعيد فجعلنا الدروس على الإنترنت.
نعم ولكن قل ما أحمقني أنا أراك قل ما أحمقني.
Tell him how foolish am I to
أن أتعلم من هذا.
To learn from you when I see
حتى أراك أن تتطور الفارس.
Arabic English Dictionary. أهم كتاب كان عندنا اسمه Hans Weir. Arabic English Dictionary.
ما أغباني حيث أتعلم منك وكم لدغت من جحر مرتين وثلاث مرات وعشر مرات.
So say, how foolish am I to learn from you if obviously your Arabic is not even at the level where you understand the book you're even trying to teach? And how many times have I been bit from the same exact hole?
العقل ما عقل عن معاطبي مثل العقال لبعير الراكب فحرفة المعاشي ليست بهدى فالضب يحفر على رأس الكدى. نتيجة العقل استخدامه حيث يمسكك من العطب مما يهلكك خصوصا في دين الله.
The interesting thing about a brain or an interesting thing about intellect is that you actually have to use it. You have to willingly use it to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to not fall into these pitfalls. You have to not just realize something, but you actually have to act upon it. You have to choose to follow your intellect willingly. So Al-Hilali said, the aql is that which prevents you from these pitfalls.
مثل العقال لبعير الراكب لأنك
يعني الكلمة اللي استخدمها قال هي ماذا؟
ما يعقلك عن مهال عن المكان عن المعاطل ما يعقلك ما 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 تقع فيه
نعم
مثل العقال لبعير الراكب أنت عندك بعير وتريد أن لا يطيع عليك أنت ما لم تعقله حتى لا يشعر
He said it's like a like some kind of a bridle or a leash to for a animal to keep it from going too far and falling in or getting away or leading to its destruction or its loss. It holds you back from that which will harm you in your deen. That's the
بحرمة المعاشي ليست بهدى كونك تحصل على بيت أو تحصل على زوج أو تأكل وتشرب هاي ليست بهدى هاي ليست بعقل.
As far as your career. To earn food, to you know, have a house and so on. That's not what intellect is about. Intellect is not about making a living.
فالضب يحفر على رأس الكبد. الحيوانات تحفر على رأس الكبد وتعيش هنا خلاص.
And his proof, he said that look, animals, they.
عندها أماكن تعهدها.
لا تخطئها. For their survival, they know exactly where to go and what.
لا تخطئها ولا تتجاوزها ولا تتقدم عنها.
They have that instinct for survival that they go exactly to the right place and they don't go beyond and so on, as far as their worldly things. But
نحن أصحاب البدو نعرف البقرة الفلانية. ما أين تبرك ونمشي نأخذها من مكانها للحليب.
And for us Bedouins, we know when we a particular cow that we own, we know exactly the same place that it chooses to nap in that it knows will find it and take it.
نقول الصبي أنت تعرف مكان بروكتك البقرة تبيها.
And we tell the children, you know where that cow goes and takes its nap. Go and.
ويعرف مكانه ما يخطئ.
And he
البقرة الفلانية تبرك في المكان الفلان.
That cow goes and sits down in that place.
الناقة الفلانية معروفة أنها ترعى في الأشجار الفلانية. خلاص.
And the camel, that particular camel, it likes the food from that, those trees over there.
ستراها عندها وكر هناك.
You'll see it goes there.
اذهب هناك. أي تعهدت ذلك المكان.
As you used to habituated to go to that place.
هذه ليست بعقل.
So that's not a sign of intellect that a person knows how to.
هذا إلهام يستوي فيه الحيوان. الله تعالى قال. وأوحى ربك إلى النحل أن اتخذي من الجبال بيوتا ومن الشجر ومما يعرشون.
This is a divinely given inspiration and instinct for survival, as Allah سبحانه وتعالى says, and your Lord has given wahi, meaning in this case inspiration to the
إلى النحل
to the bees.
أن اتخذي من الجبال بيوتا ومن الشجر ومما يعرشون. ثم كلي من كل الثمرات فاسلكي سبل ربك يقولون أن يقولون.
معنى يعرشون. That to take its homes in the mountains and the trees. I don't want to mistranslate the last
تتفنن في الأشياء.
It goes in different trees and it knows which trees to go and how to make its hive and exactly Allah gave that knowledge to engineer those hives exactly to the bee and what flowers to go to. And so on.
تتخصص في جميع
It doesn't matter the type of flower. It knows what to get from the flower and how to go and how to act.
تعرف.
It knows these things. Allah سبحانه وتعالى instilled in it this knowledge.
Specialized.
يخرج من بطونها شراب مختلف الألوان ويشفاء للناس.
And Allah سبحانه وتعالى says, and in the end, out of its stomachs come a
شراب مختلف
الألوان. That is
عسل.
Of different colors. That has benefit for the people.
فيه شفاء للناس.
That has a cure for the people.
شفاء عام للأمراض كلها.
A general cure for all illnesses.
أهل السكر وأهل الهم وأهل الغم لكن إذا كان عسل على الحال اللي يقول. كل قوم حتى
أهل السكر. Don't tell me diabetes. Don't tell me whatever. Don't tell me anxiety. Tell me honey, but pure honey, corrupted. Honey as it should be.
إذا كان على العسلية المعروفة التي تمشي تترك النحل وترعى وترجع في شفاء لجميع الأمراض.
From bees that are allowed to go
تركها
naturally to the places that they're supposed to go to different plants. Different an assortment of plants, not the same plant.
تخرج في شفاء للناس كل شخص كل
It has a cure for all people, Allah says.
أنا كنت مع شيخنا المراقب الحاج رحمه الله تعالى وأنا صغير في ذلك الوقت، وقال لي هذا عندي أخت مصابة بالسكر، قلت له مراقب نحن نحتاج رقيقة، قال خذ العسل وقرأ في القرآن، قال أعطيه لها، قلت له مصابة بالسكر، قال ما أخطأت الصواب.
So I went to Murad al-Hajj and I told him that my sister wanted some kind of ruqya for her illness of diabetes. He said, He recited the Quran and he said, give her honey to drink. I said, she has diabetes. Diabetes, they can't have sugar. This is he said, you're wrong.
أخطأت كذب الأطباء.
The doctors are lying.
الله تعالى قال فيه شفاء للناس.
Allah said it has a cure for all people.
ولذلك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عندما جاء الرجل قال اسقيه عسلا ابن أخي اسقيه عسلا الأمام قال سقيت عسلا وسال بطن قال صدق الله وكذب بطن أخي.
The same thing happened with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Where the companions came to him and said, one companion said, my brother is sick. He said, give him honey. His nephew. So then they gave him honey and he got sicker. So he came back to the Prophet ﷺ and said, we gave him honey and he got sick. He said, his illness got worse. He said, Allah has told the truth and your nephew's brother, your nephew's stomach has lied. Give him more honey. So they gave him more honey.
أتعلمون ما هي النتيجة هنا؟
Do you know what the intellectual lesson?
هذه عقول صاحبها توفيق.
That these were intellects that were paired with Allah's assistance and divine providence.
عقول مصحوبة بتوفيق.
Intellect along with providence.
المهم وعلى كل حال. أرجع إلى كلمة عمر وإلى الحديث.
سيريدون النتيجة من الحالتين.
I don't think people know what providence means.
I explained it and I translated differently both times.
ماذا؟
أنا استعملت كلمة صعبة ولكن بعد ما استعملت كلمة سهلة.
نعم المرابط الحاج عنده عقل العلم.
مرافق الحاج had that intellect and understanding. نعم ماذا حدث للمريض؟
أعطينا العسل فقط وما ضرر ما في مشكلة.
وفي الحديث.
في الحديث صدق الله وكذب بطن أخيك. سقاه بعد ذلك كان ذلك لأنه اعتقد أنه مريض ولكن كان في بطنه شيء تحتاج إلى الدواء فزالت عنه بعد ذلك شوي. نعم. قال صدق الله وكذب هذا اللي تراك هذي.
So the case that happened with the sick person. Sure enough, after the Prophet ﷺ told him again and again, give him honey, they gave him honey, and then it became worse, meaning the stomach was just, it needed to eject those contents, and then the stomach needed to be cleansed, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cleansed it through that honey, and after that, the person was cured. So it was a cure.
ظاهره كذب ولكن حقيقة وكان في أمراض.
So sometimes you see the reaction from medicine that makes one appear like they're sicker but they're getting cured. And sure enough, that was the case with that hadith. And then with Murad al-Hajj's advice, we followed it and alhamdulillah, as we expected, didn't lead to any kind of harm or difficulty for the.
تعرف النتيجة من هذا أن Murad al-Hajj عقله عقل علمي. عقله عقل علمي.
So his intellect was based on knowledge. This is the key to understanding the righteous person, and in this case,
هو العقل كما قلنا قال الهلالي ما عقل عن معاطبي.
So that عقل is not that which you gain your career and your living with. It's what you save yourself from destruction in your deen with.
بأي معاطب فوق أن يقول لك الله ويقول لك رسوله شيء ولا تعتقد في المصلحة.
And what kind of destruction is there in deen? Above being commanded by Allah and His Messenger to do something and thinking that it does not have the benefit for you. This means that we are simply in pitfalls. We have fallen in those pitfalls. So what do we have a bone to pick with? What do we have an issue with? We have an issue with the truth.
الحق ما لا تقبله أقول والباطل تلبيه قبل أن تراه.
So the truth, we reject it intellectually, and the falsehood, our intellect seeks it before it even sees it and accepts it. Whenever we're exposed with nonsense, we crave it and we yearn for it. So what kind of nonsense is there above the examples that we gave?
هو الحديث ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا أما أن تكون مصيبتنا في ديننا من ديننا فما هدف هذه مصيبة؟
We actually are supposed to ask Allah to prevent our calamity to being in our deen, as opposed to thinking that it is a part of our deen to bring a calamity to our deen.
هل صارت المصيبة في الدين ونحن نعتقد أنه دين؟ هذه أخبار من أختي.
So instead of falling into a calamity in our deen, we've fallen into the calamity in our deen, and we think that that calamity is actually the deen.
نحن كم غباوة الواحد يضيع السنة يحضر دروس وما حفظ منها شيء وما تعلق بها من شيء. لماذا يضيع وقته في أشياء أخرى؟
How can one be more foolish than to be wasting one's a year going to classes and not learning, not taking benefit? And then not even thinking about the matters that you learned while you were in that class, and not reviewing a single thing and not memorizing a single thing. And he doesn't even have any questions in regard to the content because he didn't even understand anything. So this is a great
calamity. أحزنوا إلي عليهم حزنا شديدا جدا يعني مساكين خسروا الدنيا والآخرة ما حصلوا على الأزواج ما حصلوا على الأموال وهم ضاعت أعمارهم أحزن على المنتسبين في الدين.
So I'm sad truly for those who are ascribing themselves to the deen nowadays.
ما حصلوا على أزواج ما حصلوا على أولاد ما حصلوا على أعمال ما حصلوا كانوا مويس القرني أو الإمام النووي.
They've spent all this time doing all of these things, and they haven't. They don't find themselves having wealth in their youth. They don't find themselves with children, with spouses. It seems like they just sacrificed everything for nothing.
كانك تعتقد الإمام النووي الذي منعه الاهتمام بالمسلمين وحفظ الكتب حتى أنه كان في الدرس الواحد يعلق. يعني على الشيوخ بوسط يعلق ما الاستفهامات كيف هو يزيد شرح أو يفهم.
What led Imam al-Nawawi not to get married for his whole life until he passed away at 40? Was he wasting his time and doing whatever you're doing, or was he was learning and to the level and writing even in the middle of the class he's writing commentaries.
يزيد التعليقات والشروح وزيادة.
And giving explanations deeper than what the teacher is saying in the middle of the class. He's giving his writing his the commentary to the content that is being taught in the class. So you also are, they remain to be unmarried. You also remain to be in the state where everything is sacrificed like Imam al-Nawawi. But what do you have to show for it? You've sacrificed even your health and your worldly benefit. And what are you gaining?
أعمال ضاعت.
You're wasting your lives.
هذا صحيح.
No,
sorry.
That's right.
أنا حقيقة والله أكرر المسألة وأكررها وأكررها وأكررها. والناس لا أراها تزداد لا سوء فهم هذه مصيبة.
In reality, I'm repeating the matter over and over and over, and it seems people's understanding about it is actually less. The misunderstandings increase. SubhanAllah, this is a waste of time for people that it's better for people to waste their time raising dogs than be in this state. At least with a dog you get to play with it and maybe it protects you or whatever.
تذهب إلى ما تسميه مجالس العلم وترجع مثلا صبر الأيدي هو وإذا جاءت المصيبة من حيث يرجى من الخير ما فوق ذلك من المصائب.
So if you are getting a calamity from where you're seeking goodness, then what problems are there?
واحد جاءت المصيبة من طلب الدنيا هذا شيء معتاد.
Someone gets a calamity from where they're seeking dunya, okay, that's normal.
هذا معروف جاءت ولكن تأتي الغفلة من مجالس العلم.
But gaining heedlessness from the gatherings of knowledge. A person gaining heedlessness from gatherings of knowledge. Is this true or not?
It's right.
If people are gaining heedlessness from supposed gatherings of knowledge, then how do you run away from that?
واحد يذهب إلى مجلس علم أو يحضر في النت مجلس أو يقرأ كتاب فيرجع غافل.
Person going to those gatherings heedless, attending the classes online more heedless, reading a book on their own even more heedless.
لماذا؟
Why؟
لأنه لا يفهم والمدرس لا يفهمه والكل هذا لا كأنه شيء يعني عادي يعني هذا يعني خلاف.
Because, I mean, even this is, it's just considered normal and it's a routine, and people are just going through motions. Nobody there has deceived themselves to think that they're actually learning anything or taking a benefit besides a certificate or a degree. It's accepted, it's known that this is the knowledge that we'll have. We'll just go
through
some familiarity with it, or even without even a degree or a certificate, that, oh, this is part of me being religious, that I go to these speeches. But you know that the teacher does not have that knowledge memorized. You are going yourself, and you're not understanding a lot of it and not retaining it. But as long as you're going through the motions and you look like you're outwardly religious, great. And you know, and people aren't, even in many cases, not in a deception. Not in an illusion. They know what it is, and but they don't see a problem with it. That they see it.
يقول ابن الجوزي رحمه الله تعالى أعظم المصيبة ألا تحس بالمصيبة.
Ibn al-Jawzi, may Allah have mercy on him, said that the greatest calamity is that you do not even know you're in a calamity.
واحد مصاب ولا يعلم أنه مصاب.
A person
who خصوصا في الدين.
A person who is afflicted and they don't know that they're afflicted. And what's worse is that it's in your deen.
يحسب نفسه أنه مرأة تحسب نفسها رابعة العدوية وهي رابعة المجرمة.
And a woman thinks that she's like Rabi'at al-Adawiyya, and Rabi'at al-Adawiyya, and in reality, she's a criminal.
رجل يحسب نفسه أن سفيان الثوري هو ثور.
And for a man thinks that he's سفيان الثوري, and he's a bull.
ثور. هذا كلام سبحان الله أي خسارة ناس أطفال الضيع. وشبابه يضيع ونساءه يضيعوا والبيت خارب كله يعني ممزق كله مثلا تضيع الكل وتخسر الأموال وتخسر الوقت وترجع بالخسارة.
So this is a loss. It's a loss.
تخسر الأموال.
It's a waste. You're losing your wealth.
تخسر الأوقات.
You're losing your time.
تخسر الهمم.
You're losing your determination and your energy that you're spending.
وترجع بالخسارة.
And you're coming back with nothing but loss.
يرجع مستوى الطفل وأمه ومستوى الطفل وأبوه وكل ما خرج من المجلس.
That everyone goes back equal with nothing.
عائلة كاملة تحضر المجلس.
The whole family attends and nobody got anything.
الطفل عنده قلسوة وهو أبيض.
The child has a cap, a nice white cap and white thobe.
هذا هو اللي جاء به من المجلس.
That's what he got from the gathering.
ماذا لسه ما شاء الله نصرت نلبس الثوب.
Oh, what did you gain from the gathering? Oh, I wore a cap and a thobe.
أول شيء يذهبون إلى هذا كله شبع الأمر يذهبون إلى دكان ما لما عدد وترتيب بين الأساتذة وبين طلابهم دكان إسلامي فيكون هذا تجارة هناك مخبوءة للناس تخدع به أنت تعرف أنا أعرف هذا جيدا أنا خبير أنا أخبر أنا أعرفكم جيدا
that they'll have nearby the masjid a nice Islamic shop where you can buy that one
هذا ترتيب كامل الشيخ سيأخذ المال والدكان سيأخذ المال والعوام تمشي مسكينة صفر
so ما شاء الله
سيدفع للدرس
you paid for the fee for the class the sheikh got his money you bought the clothes the shop got its money and that was the point so the point was
تبرع المسجد
mission accomplished and then they tell you hey let's fundraise for the masjid when you go there as well
هذا هنا دكان إسلامي
oh look we have an Islamic store
هذا ترتيب من الأساتذة مع طلابهم أنت تعلم هذا قل منه لا تقول أنت تعلم هذا.
Say hmm or don't say hmm. You know this is a plot between the teachers and the students.
يا إخواني ويا أخواتي عيب على العاقل أن يلدغ من جحر مرتين ما مرات.
ولكن لا بأس بذلك يعني لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال للصحابة بعضهم يجعلون تجارتهم كانت تجعل السوق قريب من يعني ليتاجروا مع المسلمين وهذه الأمور يعني. أين
قال؟
بعد في السيرة يعني حينما دخلوا المدينة.
لكن ماذا؟
فكان بعضهم دخلوا في السوق مع الكفار وجعلوا سوقهم أيضا.
ولكن ماذا فعل؟ هل المعلم يقول الناس يحضهم على
هذا؟
لا. لا أنا أعرف أنا أعرف أن أبو بكر كان تاجرا.
Yeah, I know that Abu Bakr was a merchant.
لكن كان تاجرا ماذا يفعل؟
But what he was a merchant who did what?
وعبد الله بن مبارك صاحب أبي حنيفة كان تاجرا ماذا يفعل؟
And عبد الله بن مبارك was a merchant, but what did he do?
وأبو حنيفة بنفسه كان تاجرا.
And so was Abu Hanifa.
وأصبح النعمان من فرسانه وهو يبيع البز في دكانه أصبح من فرسان العلم وهو في دكانه
and he became one of the leaders of knowledge while he was in his shop
هل كان يقود الناس اشتروا من البضاعة كان يريد أن يسد جوعته
was his
كان يريد أن لا يحتاج للناس
for knowledge to tell people to buy from me or was his purpose of being a merchant to not need the people's money
وليساعد الآخرين
and to help others
أما ليأخذ من الغرباء
that's the distinction but as for just taking money for strangers and without benefiting them that's a different story
ابن المبارك ماذا كان يفعل صاحبه
عبد الله بن المبارك
رضي الله عنهما
may Allah be pleased with them both what did he do
كان يتجر قال لولا طلاب العلم ما دخلت هذه التجارة أصلا
and he said if it wasn't for the students of knowledge I wouldn't do this business anyways But actually now it's the students of knowledge instead of sponsoring them, no, they're being milked for every penny they have.
La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Allahumma nas'aluka at-tawfiq. Allahumma nas'aluka at-tawfiq. Ana law kan wahid hafiza hukman wahidan wa ata 'alayhi milyard dollar, ana aqul hadha ribh. ولا يمكن أن يكافئ شيخه لو حفظ حكم واحد وأعطى عليه مليون دولار أقول هذا خلاص هذا الشيخ يستحق هذا ويستحق أكثر منه والطالب ما فعل شيء
So for me the value of knowledge is that if a student gave a teacher $1 million for just learning one ruling then
حفظه
I would say
وفهمه.
That okay that's an exchange the teacher in fact deserves more and the student did nothing
قال علي إنه لعبد لمن إليه من حرف يبدو فإن يشاء باع وإن شاء سرق ولكن بدل من حرف وفهمه وعمل به خلاص
علي رضي الله عنه he said that I'm a slave for a person who teaches me even one letter of knowledge
ولكن علمني افهموا علمني
he taught me one even one letter of knowledge If he wants to set me free, if he wants to sell me, he can sell me. If he wants to keep me as a slave, he can keep me.
أنا فهمت هذا الحرف وتعلمت منه وقدمني.
So that means that if he really explained to me and made me understand and memorize that letter of knowledge, not that it just went in one ear and out the other.
أما واحد جهلني فإنه ليس
خلاص. Right, that he made me actually progress and become a better person through that knowledge. As for a person who just increased me in my ignorance, then I'm not
جهلني جهلا مركبا.
That he allowed me, that now he gave me compounded ignorance.
جهلني جهلا مركبا ويحطني على الدوام عليه. أنا أقول دوم من جهر 20 مرة.
And on top of that, he tells me to persist and continue with him. Am I going to get stung 20 times?
دعونا من هذه دعونا من هذا الفهم الخاطئ وأرجو الله لي ولكم التوفيق. والله سبحانه جل جلاله يقول فبشر عبادي الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه أولئك الذين هداهم الله وأولئك هم الألباب. لا عبرة بالألفاظ بدون معان ولا عبرة بالمسميات بدون معان. دعونا من هذا الفهم الخاطئ.
So abandon this incorrect understanding.
الله تعالى يقول فبشر عبادي الذين يستمعون القول بشر
عبادي. Give glad tidings to the servants who hear the words and follow the best of them. Those are the ones whom Allah has guided, and those are the people of intellect.
علموا أن الألفاظ بدون معاني والمسميات بدون معاني تزوير.
And know that the titles without the realities are fabrications and forgeries.
وفي حديث صحيح البخاري وغيره المتشبع بمال سفيه كلابس ثوبي سوء.
And in an authentic hadith that the one who seeks to benefit by giving an impression of something that they have something that they do not have is the one who is wearing two cloaks of deception.
متشبع بمال سفيه كلابس ثوبي سوء. واحد مرة تقول متحجبة ورجل يقول بس هو يحضر دروس العلم وما يحفظ منها شيء هذا متشبع بما ليس فيه.
A person who is trying to take benefit by pretending to be something that they're not is wearing two cloaks of deception, of falsehood. That means like a woman who is trying to say oh I'm a hijabi and whatever and she's not, it doesn't
matter. أنا يتحضر الدروس.
Or saying oh I'm religious, I attend gatherings and so on and.
ما بقيت حلقة إلا ودخلتها.
There's no class except that I go to.
وهي ما حفظت شيء.
Well, she did not learn.
هذا الرجل ما بقيت حلقة يعرف الحلقات من الصين إلى أمريكا وما عنده ما تعلق به إلا ما تعلق برئيس الصين من العلم.
That this man attends classes and knows every حلقة from China to America, and he only has the knowledge equal to the.
رئيس الصين.
The leader of China.
ما عنده من العلم إلا ما عند رئيس الصين أو ترامب.
He has the same knowledge as Winnie the Pooh or Trump.
هذا صحيح. هذا صحيح.
Is this true or not? This is true.
أنا أكون شاينا وترامب وأخلي عنك هذا.
Say China or Trump, but don't make.
وهؤلاء يقدر أرفع مقام منكم. في الدنيا.
These people, they're considered higher status than you in this world.
تحلمون تحلمون بمقامهم.
You dream of their worldly status. Why are you destroying yourselves by your own hands?
سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. أنا أعتقد وأظن وأجزم أنكم ستلدغون وتلدغون 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 مما لدغتم من قبل. أعتقد.
In conclusion, I assume and I know and I believe that you will continue to be stung and stung and stung from these same avenues continuously.
هذا صحيح.
نعم صحيح.
Okay.
قلت لنا هذا من قبل وتحقق. كم مرة. That Sheikh told us this how many times before, and personally I know that it took a while for it to sink in. It took a long time, several times. But you have a lot of people around you who have also been stung similarly. Why don't they arrive to the
same?
That why don't they be in the state where at least if they've been foolish enough to be stung so many times, that at least they gained a lesson from it? Then why don't they at least reach the status of a donkey, that it is said that a repetition, that even a donkey will learn through repetition? Why can't we reach this noble status of the donkey? I know this is offensive to you and hard to hear. The scholar said that whoever does not be patient upon the bitterness of the medicine will never taste the cure.
الشفاء يحتاج إلى صبر وإلى حقا قوية جدا يعني مؤلمة 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 لأن الإنسان إذا لم تكسر شعوره وهواه وكبره ما يمكن يفهم الحق.
هذا الكبر. This requires some very severe injections to break your resistance and arrogance and ego. Otherwise, it will reject and continue to reject actually acting upon that knowledge.
اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل محمد إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم صل صلاة تامة وسلم سلاما تاما على نبي تبارك وتعالى.
هل تستطيع أن تعتمد على الشيخ ولا تتسبب؟ هل ضد العقل
أن تعتمد على الشيخ؟
يعني بدل أن تتسبب
شيخ فقط أنه فقط يرقيك بدنيا؟
تتسبب للرزق.
لا شوف الرزق أول أسباب تقوى الله سبحانه.
The question he said, what about relying on your sheikh to help you getting the rizq without asbab, without the means? Is this against intellect? نعم أظن يعني هو يسأل من جهة. Anyways, that intellect. نعم.
أنا سأقول تقوى هو أول أسباب الرزق.
The first means of sustenance is taqwa.
تقوى ما هو معناه؟
And what is the meaning of taqwa?
تعلم العلم والعمل به.
Learning knowledge and applying it.
هذا ومن يتق الله يجعل له مخرجا ويرزقه من حيث لا يحتسب. ليس معناه قد لا يكون تصب عليه الأرزاق من قد يصب عليه الأرزاق من حيث لا يحتسب بأسباب وبغير أسباب.
That yes, if a person is actually learning their knowledge and applying it, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can bless him. Allah is the one who blesses with the means or without the means.
من حيث لا يحتسب.
From where he expects or from where he does not
قد يتيسر له أسباب ما كان يحلم به.
That some means for his sustenance might appear that he never used to imagine it would exist.
أسباب رزق ستة محققة.
There are six affirmed doorways for sustenance.
توكل كما قلنا.
تقوى as we said.
توكل ما هو التوكل.
توكل reliance upon Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
ما هو التوكل؟
What is the meaning of relying upon Allah?
ليس معنى أنك تجلس فقط وتنظر إلى السماء.
Doesn't mean sitting and looking at the sky.
لا. قال عمر رضي الله عنه السماء لا تمطر ذهبا ولا فضة.
عمر رضي الله عنه said the sky does not rain gold or silver.
ألا تعلمون أنه يعلم الآية؟ أتعتقدون أنه لا يعلم الآية؟
Do you think he knows the verse or doesn't know the verse?
وفي السماء رزقكم وما توعدون.
That Allah says that in the heavens is your sustenance and that which you are
ولكن
promised.
العادي أن الإنسان يدعو ربه ويتسبب بأسباب هذا هو التوكل. التسبؤ توكل بأن تباشر الأسباب المباحة.
So tawakkul is described as taking the halal means, only relying upon the halal means Allah has provided. That is a part of tawakkul.
تفعل عمل تعتمد عليه حتى لا تكون عيالا على الناس.
So you work so that you can make a living and not so not so as not to depend upon people.
بأن تباشر الأسباب مع شهودك المدبرة.
While realizing taking those permissible means.
ليس اعتمادا عليها فقط.
Not relying upon those means, but realizing that Allah is the one who provides.
مع شهودك المدبرة أي علمي أن ما يشاءه يقع ولا يكون غير ما شاء وصنع. أي علمي.
That knowing that that whatever Allah wills is and nothing happens except that what He willed and does.
هذاني تقى توكل صلاة.
تقوى توكل صلاة.
أي أسباب الرزق.
These are the doorways of sustenance.
الصلاة. الله تعالى قال. وأمر التوكل قالوا من يتوكل على الله فهو حسبه.
Then التوكل الله سبحانه وتعالى says whoever relies upon Allah, Allah suffices him.
الصلاة قال تعالى وأمر أهلك بالصلاة واصطبر عليها لا نسألك رزقا نحن نرزقك.
For الصلاة Allah says
صلاة بشروطها وأركانها وبتقوى
الله. The prayer meaning that to learn the prayer properly, to learn the purification and to apply it properly, Allah says we do not ask you for sustenance, rather we provide it for you.
صدقة.
صدقة is a means, and the fourth of the gateway
صدقة.
Means of sustenance.
قال تعالى وما أنفقتم من شيء فهو يخلفه وخلاصه.
Whatever he gives, whatever you give, he will replace, and he is the best of those who provide sustenance.
كذاك صلاة كذاك.
خير الرازقين يعني هو الرازق طبعا.
نعم لا شك فيه. أنا يرزقك بأكثر مما تحتسب.
The best of those who provide sustenance doesn't mean there are others who provide sustenance.
لا 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 لا.
Besides Allah. It means that Allah will bless you beyond what you imagine.
Salatu salaka kadaka.
It's
istighfar. Tawba ila Allah subhanahu jalla jalaluhu. Tawba ila Allah subhanahu.
Repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seeking Allah's forgiveness.
Tawba, hadhihi al-ilaj.
Repentance to Allah is the cure.
Taharruk.
And then the sixth gateway for sustenance is working. Is taking the means.
أسباب عالية. صلاة صل الله تعالى قال لمريم عليه السلام وهزي إليك بجذع النخلة تساقط عليك رطبا جنيا فكلي واشربي وقري.
Taking the means. Allah سبحانه وتعالى says, He said to Maryam, even though it's a miracle, Allah said, take the trunk of the tree and shake it. Then the fruits will fall.
معناها أهم شيء رأس الحكمة هي التقوى.
So the core of wisdom is God consciousness.
وهذا قلنا في أول كتاب في أول
درس. The first thing that we mentioned.
التقوى رأس كل حكمة.
The taqwa is the head of all knowledge and wisdom.
الصحابة الكثير منهم تجار.
Many of
them. أصحاب زراعة.
Were merchants and farmers.
لماذا؟
Why?
لأجل أن لا يحتاج إلى أحد ولينفع الآخرين.
So they do not need anyone for their own needs, and they do, so they can benefit.
الله تعالى يقول في مثلهم رجال لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بيع عن ذكر الله وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة يخافون يوما تتقلب فيه القلوب والأبصار. يقول الله فيهم.
Allah سبحانه وتعالى says in the regard that they are men who are not distracted by
لا تلهيهم تجارهم تجار الليل والنهار في التجارة.
From the remembrance of Allah and establishment of prayer and giving in charity that they fear a day.
يخافون يوما تتقلب فيه. لا تلهيهم تجارة أصلا.
Their trade does not distract.
هم تجار.
They are merchants.
يبيعون ويشترون ولكن هذا البيع والشراء كله لله.
They buy and they sell, but all their buying and selling is for the sake of Allah.
لا يبيعون إلا بمعرفة الحكم.
They do not sell except while knowing the ruling.
ولا يضعون إلا بما يرضي الله.
And they do not place their money in except in that which is pleasing to Allah.
لذلك يخافون يوما يخافون فعل مضارع مستمر يخافون يوما تتقلب فيه القلوب والأبصار.
Why? Because they're constantly what? fearful of the day that their eyes and their hearts are flipped.
أنا قالت لأمي رحمها الله تعالى قالت لأبوك كان قال لو دعت الحاجة إلى إعطاء أغلى مال عندي فيما يرضي الله تعالى في وقت واحد أتنو ولو لم تدع الحاجة إلى ذلك لا يمكنني أن أخسر قرشا واحد. قالت لو دعت الحاجة إلى أن كل الأموال تمشي في وقت ثانوية واحدة فيما يرضي الله تعالى
that من
أبي قال كان تقول يوم أنا ما أدرك شيء
ولكن
كان يبيع ويشتري ويقوم
على buy and sell and he would say that if all my wealth had to go for something and was for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in one second that would be no problem
أغلاه يمشي في ذلك الوقت
my best wealth will go towards it in that
وإذا لم تدعو الحاجة إلى خسارتي يعني أوقي في موريتانيا على شيء
and if I can't lose a penny if there's no need for me now
لم تدعو الحاجة لخسارتي
and there if there was no need and nothing for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then there's no need to even spend a penny and it's not for the pleasure of Allah
هذه النتيجة رجال لا تلهيهم تجارة لذلك إذا ضاعت الأموال لا يحزنوا لكي لا تأسوا على ما فاتكم ولا تفرحوا بما أتاكم.
So this is subhanAllah the key here that ends up happening subhanAllah with people who are God conscious in their business that they will not become sad over missed opportunities or lost profits. Allah even says in regard to this predestiny of sustenance, Allah says so that you do not become sad over that which has missed you and you do not become prideful over that which you receive. The wealth belongs to Allah truly only. If it comes to you, use it for that which is pleasing to Allah, for it is the wealth of Allah.
And if it does not come to you,
then say to Allah, we belong and to Him we return. O Allah, reward me for my calamity and bless me with that which is better than
it.
The means you have taken, and but Allah is the one who is the provider. At the end of the day, as Allah said, so that you do not become sad over what you have missed and you do not become prideful over what you have received. That the Quran is a cure for the hearts of the people that are deceived by the love of wealth and children and desires. شيخ في كثير من الأسئلة. أنا كان عندي سؤال يعني. هل تستطيع أن يعني لا تقبل نصيحة الشيخ في وأن يأمرك شيء في حياتك العادية يعني.
الشيخ اسمع. شيخ وشيخان.
So the question is, can you disagree with your sheikh's decision making on your life? And the answer is, there's two sheikhs.
شيخ يعلم العلم ويتقي الله تعالى اقبل نصيحته لأنه ما سينصحك إلا بعد إلا إذا رأيته خالف شرع الله تعالى لأنه ما سينصحك إلا فيما هو مصلحتك لأن ابن عاشر قال يصحب شيخا عارف المسالك يقيه في طريقه المهالك وهو ما سينصحك إلا فيما بدا له الخير فيه وإلا فهو مجرم لأنه غرك.
So if there's a real, if it's a real sheikh, then and he has meaning knowledge and practice, and he volunteers advice or gives solicited advice, every word that should be given by this person, if you're taking them as a sheikh and you're agreeing that they're a sheikh, then it should only be every word that they say is that which, based on all the knowledge that they have and knowing you and understanding your situation, asking you the right questions and evaluating, they've used all their knowledge and expertise to come to a conclusion in your regard. So then you would be wise to heed that decision if they were a true sheikh that you trust in that regard, and you've seen that from them. However, If they're not, that's not the case, that you know they'll just, without even knowing the situation fully or without asking you anything further, without seeing this, without taking things into account, that means that they're used to talking without knowledge. That's not a shaykh. Because Allah says, do not act upon that which you have no knowledge of.
والإمام ابن المنذر قال أجمع المسلمون على أنه لا يحل للمكلف أن يفعل فعلا حتى يعلم حكم الله ما دام يتجرأ وينصحك بالخديعة هذا اللي كنا نتكلم عنه في أول الدرس.
And ابن المنذر said that it is not permissible, that it is consensus of the scholars, it is not permissible to do any action until Allah's ruling is known in it.
اللي كنا نتكلم عنه في أول الدرس هو اللي تلدغون في جحور مليار مرة هذا هو اللي كنا نتكلم عنه في أول الدرس.
This is the topic of the class.
Okay, say something.
فإذا رأيتم الشيخ يخالف شرع الله تعالى وعلمكم العلم النافع من قبل ولم يخرج عن الإسلام فاحترموه ولكن اتركوا.
So if you find that this sheikh of yours has taught you a beneficial knowledge, but now they're disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you've benefited from them.
ورأيتم يخالف شرع الله تعالى.
You see them going against the command
of Allah. ويتغير بالسياسات.
And they're changing to being political and whatever. Keep on respecting them, but leave them. That they are like your father, and so long as they remain to be a Muslim.
ولكن احذر من هذه النصائح. هذه الأشياء الجديدة التي غيرت هذا البرنامج الأول. هذا خطير.
هو قال يعني هو جاوب على السؤال قال سؤال من أخ لماذا أقول أخبر شخص وأقول للناس اذهبوا لل ما شاء الله للصالحين حتى العلماء وحتى يعني بعد أنني يعني قد يعني ما استفدت منهم وقد خسرت في الدين والدنيا بصحبتهم السنوات.
هؤلاء ليسوا صالحين.
نعم. These are not righteous people.
شياطين.
These are شياطين. This is, you've answered the question yourself. That's the question. There's no. Why would you
do
it? And all of you need to really, actually, this response is the response that the point of the class is. Every single one of you should see that. Well, I've been going there for years, and I haven't gotten any benefit. That is the answer for all of you. That's action speak louder than words. That's what means that you think that there it's righteousness and whatever. Are you fools? He said, feeling stupid. Please guide me. are you fools?
You would have to be a fool.
But this is your stat. This is your state.
أنتم تدخلون على الناس يوميا وترجعون ما استفدتم منهم شيء ما جرح قلوبكم ما جرح قلوبكم.
That you're going on these to these people back and forth every day for years, and what impact have they had upon your hearts?
ما جرح قلوبكم. ما كسروا قلبا منكم أصلا ما ردوا.
They did not ever once hurt your feelings for your sake. They've just pandered to your feelings and catered to what you wanted to hear all those years. They gave you what you wanted.
هذا كانوا يقولون لكم الأحمق من أتبع نفسه وهواه وتمنى على الله الأمان.
The what does the hadith mention about those who don't hurt your feelings? What about the one who just feeds your desires? The fool is the one who lets his nafs follow its desires and still hopes from Allah to reach their goals. No, you cannot be doing what's easy and
what's
easy. That's what you get from these gatherings. نعم يسأل هذا الشخص كيف نغير حياتنا لو العادات صعبة للانكسار.
هما يقول العلماء أن العادة هي عدوة العبادة.
The scholars say that a habit is the enemy of worship.
ولا أعداء ولا أعداء للإسلام من الأعراف.
And there's no greater enemy to the Muslims today than their own cultures.
لا أعلم مصيبة على المسلمين الآن أشد من أعرافهم.
And I don't know any greater enemy to the Muslims today that is more destructive than their own cultures.
لأنك أنت عاقل قلت لك عاقل وتلتزم الدين يقول لك العرف اترك ما قال الله ورسوله وتقول
Because you, mashallah, with all your intellect and your
knowledge,
mashallah, your nice hijab and beard, and you're wearing a nice Islamic thobe.
ويمنعك العرض عن شيء تعرف ما في طريقة شرعية أصلا.
That now the culture is commanding you to do something that Allah and His Messenger said don't do, and you know there's no way to justify it Islamically. You say no problem, no problem. Culture says it, let's do it.
أتعلمون أنكم تحضرون الولائم التي ما يقول الشرع بن فرعون يمكن يدخلها.
Do you know that the weddings that you have are so sinful that Fir'aun would be embarrassed to go?
والله الذي لا إله إلا هو وتسمعونني رجالا ونساء لتدخلون ولائم الأعراس وتحضرون مجالس ومساجد يستحي فرعون دخولها إن كان يستحي.
I swear by Allah that even if the Pharaoh had any shame, he would be embarrassed to go to the weddings that you go to, even in the masjids.
لو كان فرعون يستحي من الله تعالى لاستحيا منه. ولو كان الشيطان يستحي من الله لاستحيا منه.
If Fir'aun, was able to have any shame, he would have had shame, and if, the shaitan would even be embarrassed to go there if he was embarrassed in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
لماذا تحضرونها؟
And why do you go to these lessons?
للعرف.
For the sake of culture.
ليس شيء آخر.
For no other reason.
كم امتنعت نساؤكم ورجالكم من زواج شرعي للعرف؟ وبقوا على الزنا.
How often did your men and women stay unmarried because of culture and they stayed in zina?
هذا صحيح ولا لا؟
صحيح.
هذا الذي قلته كله صحيح أو كذب؟
Everything that I said is a true or false. It's true. عندي مثال شيخ سؤال.
نعم.
اليوم حدث معنا.
كل يوم سيحدث.
نعم. شخص قال لي شخص آخر صلي مع هذا الشخص اللي كان يصلي منفردا. فرآه كان مفتي حنفي موجود فقال الذي قال لك هذا الشخص خاطئ في المذاهب الأربعة لا يحل للناس لا يجوز أن تصلي خلف شخص بدأ صلاته منفردا قال هذا في المذاهب الأربعة
وحديث صحيح البخاري يعلمه؟
لا يعلم أكيد
هذا المذاهب الأربعة يجوز المذاهب الأربعة كلهم يجوز
حتى الحنفي الذي بدأ صلاته منفردا فالشخص يأتي
ويصلي
نعم أنا قلت له الإمام لا تشترط عندنا النية فهو ما فهم ذلك الدليل ما فهم قال لا أنا لا أكلمك عن النية أعطيني اللفظ أن قلت له الإمام فقط يحتاج النية أصلا يكون حتى لو لا يدري أنه فما فهم So here's an important point This same mufti that keeps being brought up today mashallah we had another interesting meeting that there was a brother who was praying by himself and another brother came in so I told that brother go pray with this brother so you get your jama'ah so afterwards this Hanafi mufti said no in all four madhabs you're not allowed to pray with and I at least studied the Maliki madhab in front of him but he just said in all four madhabs you're not allowed to pray And then he kind of said, I don't know later, after making the claim of saying it, then he said, but no, I know in Hanafi and Hanbali. I told him, I know in Maliki and Shafi'i that you can. But I don't know, you know, Hanafi and Hanbali. Hanbali, I asked a Hanbali, a guy who said he was Hanbali before, and he said it was allowed, but I haven't read the thing myself. So I know it's in two or three madhab that you can. He said, no, in all four madhabs, you are not allowed to pray behind the person who started their prayer individually. You're the one who's foolish for studying with such a person before. This is the same guy who told me to read and whatever. Of course, I know from context.
أنا هذا أسمع رجل هذا وحده البخاري جاء رجل دخل الصلاة وحده فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم اعطوا لصاحبكم من يصلي
إن حديث صحيح بخاري that a man was praying and then he was praying by himself the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said somebody go pray with him
لكن قال هو ما دام يقفز على المذاهب الأربع هو ما يعرف أين المذاهب الأربع من قال
How is this person claiming to know mashallah the four madhabs Even Murabit al-Hajr is not going to say a claim about the four madhabs with that ease. And forgive me, I told him I know that the three
madhabs.
Sorry, I gave him a proof. I didn't translate that part. I gave him a proof that I said, in at least in our madhab, you only need to have the intention to even be the imam. Like somebody can pray with you, you never intended to be the imam whatsoever, and somebody prayed and you don't know that they're praying with you, and you never had any intention to change yourself to an imam, and the prayer is valid. I said that except in four cases, the jama', the person who's replacing the imam, and the fear prayer. I said, I know this memorized. And he said, no, he said, even, the, and he still is saying, baby, you're wrong. He said, bring me the you should have told him I'm wrong, but for what? For what? That you ever studied with him before.
Yes, I'm wrong.
That even Marabit al-Hajj, subhanAllah, he would hesitate to say four madhabs. That you have to learn first to make a claim like that. So if you've studied with that person before, then you haven't studied. That you're saying that he had to look at the, you have to both pull up the
English.
How can a person who is their Arabic is not at that level says, you know, look at the four. Or even one
madhab.
Or even the purification. Even purification from one madhab.
SubhanAllah, in the same gatherings where people, you know, they're not getting any knowledge, now in Davis v. Davis, the women are sitting all in front of the young men, so all, they can see all the women in front of them without the hijab and, you know, with the hijab.
If woman, Maryam ibn Amran, عندها hijab, لا تجلس أمام الرجال.
If a woman, subhanAllah, is Maryam ibn Amran, she would not sit in front of the men even if she had a hijab. Why would she sit in front of men? She wants to be a fitna for them. Of course. Unless, you know, the men are... I have no masculinity. Then perhaps...
إذا كنتم عندكم ما زلتم رجال هذا شيء وما دمتم غير رجال صرتم تشتهون الرجال الآخرين أكشي قولوا.
So if you no longer retain any natural human attraction, you know the deen accounts for this by having the you know the women out of you know not in the line of sight and men in acts of worship. Because men women are supposed to be a fitna for men. That's how Allah Subhanahu wa Taala created. That whole exchange. If a man is healthy, he's going to be attracted to a woman. But now, unfortunately, if a man, subhanAllah, if a person is, you know, either, you know, they have no desires or they're, you know, homosexual, that's a different, that's your orientation, that's one thing, but if you are, you know, psychologically, you know, what did the Prophet say? He said, I have not left a more harmful temptation for the men of my ummah than women. A young man, you know, in his peak of his youth, he's he'll even, subhanAllah, be attracted to a female, you know, a monkey. If men are causing temptation for men here in America. So some of your women people are just from the Muslims. Women are attracted to women and men attracted to men. This is going beyond the human nature. So then how could a man then not be attracted to
men?
This is, you've gone beyond your just what attraction has led people to is beyond. This is not that people don't have attraction.
People
don't even care about the normal human boundaries. The nature of a man is to be attracted to a woman. This is normal human nature.
زين للناس يحبوا الشهوات من النساء والبنين بدأ بالنساء قبل الأولاد.
نعم هذا شخص يشكرك ويقول تعرفنا أكثر مما نعرف أنفسنا وهذه حالة حزينة نحن فيها. ما شاء الله لحى كبار وفي البيت زينة. That the brother said thank you Sheikh Salik and everybody else. Please tell Sheikh you know. Us more than we know ourselves. It's very sad. Big beards and zina in homes. شخص آخر يسأل السلام عليكم شيخ كيف شخص
of course. If you want to say حق.
Big beards and zina in homes. Now.
Big حجاب زينة. Big نقاب زينة. Big beard زينة. Big ثوب زينة. All of you know that.
Yes.
You know that. You accept or not accept, I don't want to tell me, yes, I know, me, I know that.
يقول السلام عليكم شيخ ماذا نفعل لو عندنا مشكلة الوسوس? And that's the last question.
الوسوسة.
نعم.
الوسوسة. داؤها. ما هي معنى الوسوسة? الوسوسة لا تأتي إلا شخص دخلت الخشية ابتداء ولا تدوم إلا على أحد في نقص. وعلى كل حال هي تأتي ابتداء للمخافة وتزول بعد ذلك وعندها أمور ترك وأولها كل ما شككت فيه تترك.
So just a summary, waswasa is a person thinking, oh I didn't do this or I didn't do or did I do that in my wudu? Did I pray this many rak'ahs? Did I do this? That they'll be questioning everything. This is a natural occurrence that happens very normally when two cases, two things coincide. That a person is now, they have fear of Allah in their heart. If a person has no fear of Allah, he's not going to care. I did the how many rak'ahs. So a person must have fear of Allah in their heart. So it comes with a good sign. But also maybe they're new in their studies or they have some kind of spiritual weakness or they haven't fortified themselves yet or haven't gained the knowledge to protect themselves from it. So the shaitan sees them as vulnerable and attacks them at this crucial stage. Almost everybody who goes through their beginning stages of knowledge and practice will experience some level of waswasa. And the first medicine of it is to abandon it. Your ruling will change in fiqh, but in order for you to be able to abandon those whisperings. Whatever you think you didn't do, you're counted as having done. And even if you did only three rak'ahs for dhuhr because you said, did I do three or four? You're counted as four. Even if you're, did I do my arms in wudu? You're counted as having done them. Whatever you're having waswasa about, if you don't do it again, then you'll be rewarded as having done it. And that's going to stop you from having waswasa later.
Ya Rabbi nas'aluka at-tawfiq. Ya Rabbi nas'aluka at-tawfiq. Ya Rabbi nas'aluka at-tawfiq. Ya Rabbi nas'aluka at-tawfiq. يا رب نسألك التوفيق يعلم وفقني الله وإياكم أن هذه الصورة مطلوبة ظاهرا ولكن المطلوب هو داخل الإنسان.
That know my brothers and sisters that these and may Allah help all of us through His providence that these outward, external images of Sharia, like having a beard and hijab and so on, these are things that are commanded externally. However, it is not to focus on the external and forget the internal. What is commanded is the heart that is in a state that is reflecting the reality of those external
commands.
That makes those external things realities. Whether a person is praised or insulted for these things, they don't care. That's why you find a person who is solid in his deen, he doesn't care for praise or blame. The people praise him or blame him, he's unchanged.
لا يتغير شيء من
هذا. Doesn't change anything.
ثم أحمد.
Whether he is praised or
شكرا قبحا شيء شيء.
Thank you or you suck doesn't matter.
ما شاء الله جزاكم الله خيرا شكرا كثيرا.
Thank you very much.
إذا قالوا شكرا قل أنا أعرف نفسي أكثر منكم.
If they say thank you, oh wow, how a greater person you are, say I know myself better than you.
وإذا قالوا قبحا قل نعرف أنا أسوأ من ذلك.
You tell yourself I know myself better than you. And if they tell you you suck, then say you're right, I know myself better than you.
Yeah, أنا أعرف أن هناك أشياء أخرى.
Yeah, I know there's
a lot of things. الحمد لله على خفايا الأمور.
Alhamdulillah that you know you're saying I'm suck based on what you see and not knowing the reality of how much I really suck.
ما نتقول ما شاء الله سمعتم بمثلي أنا عن العالم الفلاني وأنا
الآخر. Not saying ما شاء الله. Have you heard? You heard of me? How dare you? You know I'm scholar so and so.
يا الله ما شاء الله كم درست كم درست وكم الكتب التي قرأتها فوق العد ممكن نعم فوق العد ممكن. استغفر الله من الرياء يا إخواني وأخواتي هذه العقول ما عقلت عن المعاصي
Again my brothers these intellects have not spared you from falling into these pitfalls.
أخبركم عن المعاصي والرجوع إلى الحافلة قبيح على العاقل.
And returning to those same pitfalls tells
والرجوع على غار لدغت منه من قبل ومسألة خسرت فيها من قبل عيب عليك.
And returning to those same things that have destroyed you before is shame upon you.
ورجوع إلى صحبتي لم تنفعك شيء عيب.
And going back to the same company that has not benefited you, or the same teacher who's claiming your purification who has not uplifted you, this is a shame upon you.
لو وفقنا الله إياكم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال المرء على دين خليلي فاليوم أحدكم من خالي.
No, may Allah help all of us that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that an individual is on the way of their closest friends, so they one should be careful who they accompany closely.
عن المرء لا تسأل واسأل عن قرينه فكل قرين بالمقارن يقتل.
So do not ask about the individual but ask about his closest friends, because an individual is upon the way of those who are closest.
فقط عن صاحب فلان.
Ask about their friends. Ask about the company he keeps. You're told he goes to the foolish speakers.
إذا قال لك واحد الآن إنه يصحب speakers، أقول له أنت رئيس الضالين.
If somebody tells you that he goes to the speakers, then tell him you are the leader of the.
أنت ما عندك أمل في صلاح الدين ولا الآخرة.
That if you continue upon that, you have no hope of being corrected in this world or the next.
مطلقاً.
At all.
أول الآن المجرمين هم المحاضرون. أول.
The greatest criminals.
أول طبقة من المجرمين هم المحاضرون.
The greatest criminals, the top tier criminals, are the speakers today.
أنا قلتها لكم مرات معذرتني إلى ربكم ولعلهم يرجعون.
And I've told you this many times. Why? Many times because just to show my excuse in front of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. In front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, each one of us will provide their proofs.
كلكم.
Each one of you individually.
كلكم سنتقابل أمام الله تعالى ونقول يا رب وأنت أعلم هؤلاء الجماعة
كلهم. We will meet in Allah's court and I will be able to say, Oh Allah, you know, I have delivered this message in regards to
هؤلاء الجماعة حذرتهم من المحاضرين.
Those people, I have warned them from the speakers. They're a destructive poison. A fatal poison. As Sheikh Murad has said. They're great enemies of Islam. I did not see any goodness from them at all. I did not know of any goodness from them.
هل تعلم منهم خيرا؟
هذا نفس هذا الشخص الذي ذكرناك من مرة هو أنا
جئت
معه لأتبع هو قال لي لابد أن تتبع مذهب أنا قلت له أنا قرأت في كتاب صلاة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أن من إن صح الحديث فهو مذهبي. فهو صححني في هذا الأمر فاستفدت منه ذلك وأكثر.
ما تستفيد منه شيء ما خرب عقلك. سدى سدى سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون سلام على المرسلين الحمد لله على حلمه بعد علمه على عبده بعد قدرته. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الفقر إلا إليك ومن الذل إلا لك ونعوذ بك أن نقول زورا وأن نغشى فجورا ونعوذ بك من شماتة الأعداء ونعوذ بك من شماتة الأعداء ونعوذ بك من شماتة الأعداء وعضال الداء وخيبة الرجاء وفجاءة النوم وتحول العالم يا من لا تراه العيون ولا تخالطه الظنون ولا يصفه الواصف ولا تغيره الحوادث ولا يخشى الدوائر يعلم مثاقيل الجبال ومكاييل البحار وعدد قطر الأمطار وعدد ورق الأشجار وعدد ما أغلم عليه الليل وأشرق عليه النهار لا تواري منه سماء سماء ولا أرض أرض ولا بحر ما في قعر اجعل خير أعمارنا أواخرها اجعل خير أعمارنا أواخرها اجعل خير أعمارنا أواخرها وخير أعمالنا خواتيمها وخير أيامنا أياما نلقاك فيها. اللهم ألف على الخير بين قلوبنا وأصلح ذات بيننا واهدنا سبل السلام ونجنا من الظلمات إلى النور وجنبنا الفواحش والفتن ما ظهر منها وما اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معاصيك ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا. اللهم متعنا بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوانا ما أحيتنا واجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثارنا على من ظلمنا وانصرنا على من عادانا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا يا رب ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا من لا يرحمنا يا رب يا رب يا رب يا رب بجاه نبيك المصطفى رسولك المرتضى طهر قلوبنا من كل وصف باعدنا عن مشاهدة الطمع وأمتنا على السنة والجماعة والشوق إلى لقائك. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على محمد بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على محمد عدد خلقك ورضا نفسك وزينة عرشك ومدار كلمتك سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك ونتوب إليك. ربنا اسألك التوفيق.